Hi, my name is Frank and I'm working on the PLSync's runtime management at Phoenix Contact. Last time I introduced you already the basic ideas of the new real-time data logger. Today I like to demonstrate you how you can configure the data logger on record on time and how you can read the database from your IPC and how you can open the database in a very easy way with a simple SQL Lite viewer. So let's have a look on my screen.
Before we can start with the configuration of the data logger, we need to have some data to record. For that, I created a very small PLSync engine application. Let's have a look at that. This tiny application, I have a program called Generator. The generator just chains and toggles a few data, like a value called OBC-RayWorld, integer, string. So all those variables are declared as outports. In fact, you can take every port type you need, as long as it's a GDS port. The program itself is instantiated on the PLC Next ESM core. Let's have a look. So, I have a few cyclic tasks. This one is for now not that interesting. Go to the next one. I have here a cyclic task with a 20 milliseconds. And here you can find an instance of the program generator. On the port list, you can see now the ports we declared. Generator, OBC array word, string, integer. So far, so good. So, deploy now the application to your PLC. Open for that the cockpit of the PLC, connect to the device, and perform the download. Okay, now you can see that the ports are changed in a random number, just counting something up, and the string is also changing as well. So, but now we want to configure the data logger. And in this case, we're using a configuration file for that. In later versions, it will be possible to do that directly in PLSync Engineer, but you will see it's not that complicated. So, just go ahead and have a look on the configuration file itself. Okay, now we open the folder which we downloaded from the PLSync GitHub repository, the folder services. This folder we will deploy later on the PLC. But what is in the folder? In the folder, you will find another folder of the service data logger. And in the folder data logger, you find a configuration file called data-logger.config. Open this configuration file. It's a quite simple XML file with the most important settings of the data logger. What do we have here? A general name of the data logger, a sampling interval, which is, I guess, quite clear, a publish interval, and a buffer capacity. Those both are very important. What does it mean? The buffer capacity means the size of the WAM disk where the single data points are stored. Every port here, every configured port, will count as one value in here. So the publish interval is the interval where the stored data ports are copied to the database itself. So the next line defines the database. So the location of the database, the max file size, in this case 10 megabytes. In fact, just a limitation of the size of the flash or of the external SD card. Later on, it will be also possible to segmentate the files, for that the key rollover is there. And now we come to the port definition. In this area, you declare every data port, GDS port, which should be recorded in the data logger. So where you can get this information? Go back to PLSync Engineer. Switch to offline. And you can see here already the string of the data port. Just open it and copy it to the config file. Where's all the blanks? Go ahead to the point. Proceed in the same way with all the other ports you want to record. In addition, I will make now a few changes to the configuration itself. So I will change here, it's Frank's database. Publish interval is quite okay, if the rest is also fine. I will change the name of the database and also to Frank's database. All fine. Just save that. Close the editor. And now we open WinSCP. So type in the IP address of your device. Okay, and now we go directly to the project folder. The project folder is a location where we have now to copy the configuration. So just go ahead like this, drag and drop, ready to go. And now we perform a restart of the PLC and the data logger will be activated. We connect back again to the PLC, open the cockpit, perform a restart. Of course, you can do the restart also via bash or just a power reset. We're waiting now that the PLC is coming back. So after the PLC is rebooted, we can have a look to the database and we can copy the database from the PLC. Go back to WinSCP and open once again the services folder, go to data logger. Now you can find here the created database, it's called FrankDB. We can copy now the database, for example, to our desktop. We can read it out. To read the database, we need a quite special tool because it's a database in the SQLite format. Therefore, that many free available databases, I'm using this small program. It's called DB Browser for SQLite. You can see it's an open source freeware tool where you can easily check your databases. The usage is also quite easy. Open the database, it's located on the desktop, in my case, open, and you can browse the data. You can see here now the string type, the word type, and also the OPC UA int type. See all the numbers and also the timestamp. The timestamp is stored in a double integer format, which makes it more performant. But you can easily convert it to any time format unique. You can also query the database with any other tools you want to have. This is just to verify and to check the database. That was all for the configuration of the database. So in the next episode, I will show you how you can read all the historicals by using OPC UA Historical. See you then, wish you a good time, and bye-bye.